The second common architecture for internet services is referred to as functionally heterogeneous. In these kinds of architectures, different nodes are designated to perform certain functions, or even to handle a particular types of requests. For instance, the request may be divided among the servers based on the request content, such as when the requests are divided based on the alphabetical order of the requested file name. Or for a service such as eBay, servers may be designated to perform browsing requests versus buying or bidding requests. With this design, it is still possible to have all of the data in some distributed shared file system and accessible to all of the nodes. But if the functions are somehow designated to be executed only on some subset of the nodes, then it is possible that not all of the data, not all of the state, will be necessary to be made available across all nodes in the system. So there's some optimization opportunities there. Clearly, one benefit of this approach is that every single node in the system is more specialized for some of the tasks that it performs or for some of the state that it needs to serve. And therefore, it is more likely that it will take advantage of some benefits like caching and locality. There are also some obvious trade-offs. The first one is that the front end will now need to be more complex because it will need to parse sufficient portion of the incoming requests so as to be able to figure out which one of the underlying nodes this particular request should be passed to. Second, the overall management of these systems becomes more complex. When nodes fail or when request rates increase and we need to add more machines, it is important to know what kinds of machines to add, how to configure those machines, what types of requests or tasks are those machines supposed to be designated for. Also, even if something changes in the workload pattern and all of a sudden there are more requests of a certain kind, then we have to reconfigure this. We can't just redirect those access of requests to some of the other nodes if they're not capable of processing those kinds of actions or serving that kind of data. So that may even be the case if the other nodes are otherwise idling. The result of that is that it is much more easy in these kinds of environments to end up with situations in which some of the nodes are hotspots, and then there are long backlogs of pending requests for those kinds of nodes.